Now you ought to learn to control that temper of yours. You're getting more like a fucking mother every day. Well, what's good enough for her ain't good enough for you.
Hey, Jennifer.
Uncle, what are you doing here?
What happened to you? Wait here, okay?
Who the hell are you?
Why don't you just think of me as a friend of the family?
Get the fuck out of my house, asshole.
Well, if you give me a couple minutes of your time, got a few things I'd like to talk to you about. You know, what you did wasn't really your fault. It's what they call a genetic defect. Mom called it the gene. My grandfather had the gene. He came over on the boat from Ireland in 1912. And I guess he passed it on to my old man. My old man was a great guy. Real pussycat, you know, hard worker. Big sports fan. Sometimes on his way home from the docks, he liked to stop in with the guys and have a couple of beers, you know. Remember coming home from school one day and the whole house was dark. Couldn't figure it out. Heard my mom crying off in the dark someplace. And I was old enough at that point I could reach the light switch. I turned the lights on, and I saw what he did to her. So I went to my room, and I got the baseball bat, Mickey Mantle model my old man gave me for Christmas. And I found the old man passed out in the bathtub, and I tattooed him. Needless to say, when I came home every day from school after that, the house is lit up like Ebbets Field. The old man never drank again. So, all I'm saying to you is if you want to drink, you go ahead and drink. But if I ever find out that you laid your hands on that little girl again, me and Mr. Mantle are going to pay you a visit, my friend.
Are you done?
Yeah, I'm done.
Good.
Oh. When you're way out, send that little whore back in here. I haven't finished with her yet.
Thank you.